Did you know there's a Lord of the Rings-based exit game? Well, now you do. And you get to hear what we thought of it in a totally spoiler-free way.
Exit the game, The Lord of the Rings, Shadows Over Middle-earth, like all of the exit games before it and probably many after it, come from the twisted minds of Inca and Marcus Brand, and is published by KOSMOS, who we do have to thank for hooking us up with a review copy of this escape room game.
The box for this exit game lists it as being for 1 to 4 players, which actually seems a bit high. There's only really one puzzle you can split up the work on. We played with 4, and often people were bored, and one person was trying to solve the puzzle while everyone else was just sitting there.
The component quality is good and matches what we come to expect from the exit games. This particular one had quite a few unusual objects, most of which were made of very thin cardboard, which worked well enough for what they were used for.
Now, one thing I did really like in the Lord of the Rings exit game was the unique artwork. There's lots of Middle-earth artwork out there, and instead of using that, they hired the Miko to do all the work. And as regular listeners know, I love the Miko's work. And I especially loved his golem. I loved the golem. We should have kept the golem card when we recycled the game. I didn't realize that. We should have kept the golem card. I could have put it up on my corkboard.
Exit the game, The Lord of the Rings, follows the plot of the original trilogy. It slips you into the narrative by having you play as hobbits who are working with Gandalf behind the scenes, helping out the fellowship in ways they will never know.
Now, gameplay here is the standard exit game format, presented in a very linear fashion where you have to solve one clue before you can move on to the next. Clues are presented through a mix of a full-color booklet and cards. The answer to each clue will be a 3-digit number. That will you input onto a code wheel, which will lead you to drawing a card that, if you are correct, will lead you to draw more clues to go deeper in the book.
Now, we don't want to spoil anything here, but I will say there's a wide range of puzzles here and quite a few of them, a lot. It felt like more than previous exit games, but I might be off on that. Many of them do require you to cut, fold, and or write on game components. So not only is the game one and done as far as knowing the answers, it'd be also be very difficult to preserve this one to pass it on to someone else.
You would have to go really far out of your way to make this game replayable. I would almost say it's impossible. The puzzles here range from simple, easy to solve, to completely obtuse and totally stumping our family. We needed clues to get through 2 of the puzzles, though we never had to look at the final solution. And the entire game took us over 2 hours, giving us a score of only 6 out of 10.
I think we should point out that you two are not exactly Tolkien rookies or anything. Depending on when you're hearing this, you may have just in fact heard the read review of the One Ring RPG, which was completed before playing this game. So a lack of knowledge about the Tolkien history in the books is not the issue.
Yeah, but to be fair, nothing here had to be Lord of the Rings. Like, it was just another exit game from KOSMOS. There were a few tie-ins, like you had to answer riddles from Gollum, and there was a clever puzzle about the gaze of Sauron, but like there was nothing that knowing about Middle-earth would help at all. Like, Middle-earth knowledge was definitely not required to this game, and heck, I've seen some hardcore Lord of the Rings fans on BoardGameGeek comments point out exactly how at least one solution actually breaks canon.
Yeah, well, the artwork and the backstory were Lord of the Rings inspired. The puzzles were not. They were thematically tied in only the very slightest of ways. On the bright side, though, for those with no Lord of the Rings knowledge, it will not hold you back from playing this game.
So if you're looking to complete the Exit series, you don't have to read the Lord of the Rings books before you play this one.
Yeah, the biggest problem here was some puzzles felt more frustrating than clever, even after learning the answers. The box gives this one a difficulty of 2 out of 5. I've got to say, I found this to be one of the harder exit games we've played.
Yeah, I found this game frustrating and frankly unfun. The puzzles weren't really tied to the theme. They were abstract and sometimes very vague. I think the best spoiler-free way I can describe it is that many times we would come up with 2 equally viable solutions, and then from there we were just guessing.
Yeah, and that's tough. When you can come up with multiple solutions, that's a concerning aspect of these.
Though I do have to say one of the benefits of the exit system is you are not punished for making a wrong guess, as you are in many of the other games. And this is not an app-driven game. There is an app. You can get an app, and it'll give you a timer with some sound effects. But you are punished for how long you take, and if you use clues, though, for your final score. As a Lord of the Rings game, I was hoping for more interesting story, maybe some new pieces of lore or canon, or I don't know, at least headcanon, or even some bad fanfic. It just followed or preceded the Fellowship and solved unrelated puzzles, just didn't do it for me. I would have much preferred a completely unrelated tale that wasn't tied to the actual events of Lord of the Rings, maybe happening at the same time. Or if they're going to follow the books, maybe not follow them step by step. I'd say more, but I think any example I gave would spoil at least some of it.
In the storyline, if I remember correctly, they referred to our group as a second fellowship. Like, the game expects you to be a group when you're playing it, yet those puzzles were some of the least group-friendly puzzles I have ever played. And like, each one needed to be held up closely by one person at a time to solve it. And not just because I have crappy eyes. The kids were having, the same sort of thing. It's just stuff you had to pick up, manipulate, look at closely. Only one person can really be doing it at a time. It did not feel like a group activity.
Yeah, unfortunately, while we have been fans of the Exit series in general, it appears that the thematic versions are a little less solid than the more, I don't want to say generic, but non-IP related Exit games.
Yeah, overall, Exit the Game, Lord of the Rings, Shadows over Middle Earth was just a disappointment for us. I think I would have liked it well enough if it didn't say Lord of the Rings, if it was just some fantasy escape room game. But putting Lord of the Rings on this just made me expect more in terms of story and more in terms of thematic tie-in. Heck, you didn't even get a plastic ring tchotchke in the box at the end to keep at the end.
Yeah, and maybe that's the problem here. Maybe I'm being too hard on the game because I had the bar in my head set too high. I was so excited to do a Lord of the Rings themed escape room game. And this was more like an escape room game with some Lord of the Rings artwork.
Yeah, it's tough, especially the more escape room games we do, and the range of escape room games from the very high end wooden boxes back down to 18 cards in a deck escape rooms, trying to find the right balance and the right expectations for each of them is very difficult. And sometimes putting your IP on something changes those expectations more than you might think.
Now, if you do love the Exit series of games from the brands and KOSMOS, you'll probably want to pick this up if you haven't already. It really does fit the mold of their games, and it does impress me how they keep coming up with new puzzles. The brands have to be brilliant. Like, I don't know how they keep coming up with new ways to use these small boxes. And there was definitely stuff in this game I'd never seen before. So props to them for this.
If you like the Exit games, you'll probably enjoy this one. I mean, I enjoyed the Exit series. I think of all the ones that we played, this one would score the lowest for me. But it doesn't stop me from wanting to play the next Exit game we happen to run into.
One thing you didn't mention, what was the kids' overall feeling? How did they walk away from it?
Again, I set the bar too high because I was like, guys, this is going to be fantastic. We're going to play a Lord of the Rings game. It's A, and that's awesome. B, it's going to be an Exit game. We all love Exit games. And we just made the kids sit through the Lord of the Rings movies to prep them for playing this game so they would be fully bought in. We were just a little too excited about it.
Yeah, and the one problem, we didn't quite get through all of Return of the King because Gwen has, like, you put a TV on in front of her and she passes out in about half an hour. So it was split over multiple nights. And Jem was disappointed because there's spoilers if you don't know Lord of the Rings. Not that I feel Lord of the Rings really needs a spoiler warning. It's been around for a very long time. But for anyone who does care about that, this will completely spoil the movies. I don't know. If you aren't an Exit game fan, if you tried them before and are like, nah, I didn't really like them, this one's not going to win you over. Like, of all the ones we played, this is my least favorite Exit game. For the same reason, I definitely don't recommend this as your first Exit game experience, which is where I think KOSMOS might have faltered a bit here, because I think by throwing the license on it, they probably got a lot of new people to check out the series, and I really don't think it's the best example. I think this would have been even more hard if not impossible without using clues, if we didn't have some idea of the tricks the brands like to put into their games.
Yeah, I think in order to play this game, you just had to understand the concept of the exit game. And if you didn't have that going in, you probably have a less enjoyable experience.
For Lord of the Rings fans, you can skip this, really. Unless you're a total completionist and need every Tolkien-inspired game out there, there's nothing new for you to experience here. Though I guess if you really want Miko's take on Middle-earth, you get to see that.
So at this point, the ring is destroyed and our hobbit helpers are exhausted from their ordeal. It's time for a rest, or maybe that's the second breakfast bell. While they put their hairy feet up for a bit, I want to know, what is your favorite Lord of the Rings game? Tell us about it in the comments or hit us up on social media, anywhere under Tabletop Bellhop, one word, pretty much everywhere.
Now, what better way to relax than to put on a comfy new outfit and grab a cup of your favorite brew? And now you can do both and rep the Bellhop brand with a 15-ounce Bellhop mug and one of our great-looking and fitting t-shirts. Just head to tabletopbellhop.com/merch. For a limited time, buy any two items, like I said, a t-shirt and a mug, and get free shipping up to $25.